me his business plan. At the beginning, right before the turn of the year. And he sent me his business plan, and on that business plan, I saw the number 13.1. And when I saw that number, I knew that that 13.1 stood for a half marathon. I'd never run a half marathon. And I started having these thoughts in my head. Could I run a half marathon? Could I do something like that? I've never done it. But I got excited that this individual that I was mentoring and coaching, I had the opportunity to be a part of his life. That he had made that one of his goals. And I picked up the phone and I called him and I said, Mike, I said, are you going to run a half marathon? He said, you better believe it. April 15th, the Go St. Louis Half Marathon. I said, have you ever run one? And he said, I've never run one. I said, I have never run one either. But guess what? I'm going to do it with you. And I printed off this training schedule off the internet. I had no idea what I was doing. I felt half crazy. My first training run was like 2 miles. And I felt like I was in pretty good shape, but I was not in running shape. And I'll never forget, I'm sitting in my coach's office. He's one of the top sports psychologists in the world, right? So I got to keep my mind right in what I'm saying to Jason. And I tell him, Jason, I'm training for this half marathon. And he says, you are? He goes, that's fantastic. And I said, there's only one problem. I hate running. He says, don't ever talk like that anymore. See, there's power in what you say and how that feeds your mind. You have to learn to love to run, to embrace every day, right? Every training run, you have to learn to love it. So I looked at him, I said, I'm going to love it. I went home. I told my beautiful wife, Amy, I said, Amy, I said, I need some training clothes for Christmas this year. Right? It gets cold in St. Louis in the winter. I work out at 4 o'clock in the morning. The price of greatness is sacrifice. I got 2 beautiful young babies, so I got to get up early. So we got young kids. I had to have the cold weather clothes. 18 degrees outside. Cold weather gear running at 4 o'clock in the morning. It was tough. Step by step by step, and I learned to love to run. I'll tell you, I had some awesome tunes. Did anybody like that Eye of the Tiger? Ooh, I jammed that Eye of the Tiger every day. I had all kinds of good stuff going. And I would jam those tunes, and I'd go step by step by step, passing those dark houses, loving those runs. And all of a sudden, I made it all through the training, because I continued to believe in that future that I had grabbed, and I put it right here, day by day, training schedule by training schedule. And I got fired up, because the run was here. It was April 15th. I got so excited. I walked up to that line to start that race. I looked out, and there were thousands of people running this race. Thousands of people. And that shotgun went off, and I mean, I took off running. I was giving it everything that I had. I was feeling great. I said, I can do this, step by step. I get to mile 4. And as I approach mile 4, I'm giving it everything I've got. I'm looking at all the beautiful scenery of St. Louis, Missouri. And then I turn and I look over my right shoulder, and here comes a woman that blows by me, pushing a baby stroller. And I said to myself, oh my goodness, I think I hate running. And you know what made it worse? Her kid looked like he weighed about 50 pounds. But you know what I had to do at that point in time? I had to check in mentally. See, because when I trained, I didn't train to race against the woman pushing the stroller, did I? I trained for that race because I believed that there was something that I could do. I believed that with this young man that I coached, that we could have the blessing of accomplishing something together. And I checked in with my head, my heart, my gut. I connected all three and I said, it doesn't matter who else blows by me. What matters is that I will finish this race. And I finished this race. There's still blood on the back of my tennis shoes from my ankles. But the key is, I finished. So I'd say to each and every one of you, define your dream. Define your journey as you go down this road. Because from what I've heard, it can only get better. And from what Reuben said, I'll tell you, it was the truth. He was preaching the truth, everybody. The truth is that the weak people will live, but the strong will get stronger, and they will move forward, and they will grow their dreams, and they will experience growth that they never thought possible because they held on during the tough times. It's just how it works. Go and read the biographies, study companies. It's just how it works. You have got to hold on and identify those things that fire you up to keep going every day.